So here we are having this formula a, a minus b whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square. Okay, so this is a formula, okay, general formula. We are familiar about this formula. So we'll use this formula here. Okay, so to open this bracket. So if we open the bracket, then your equation will become mt is equal to m sigma b then y r, and we are taking 1 b common from this bracket, and after solving directly you will get this equation as 1 minus b divided by a naught plus b square divided by 3 a naught. Only a naught will be there, so 3 a naught. So this will be your final equation. Okay, so you just put all these values in the previous formula. Okay, and if you simplify, you will get this. And 1b will be there, and we have taken that b common. So actually, the equation was b minus b square by a naught plus b cube by a naught 3 a naught, like this. And we have taken b common, so 1 minus b by a naught plus b square by 3 a naught. Now here, the assuming the beam strength is a tangential force at the large end, so we are having torque is equal to tangential force at large end multiplied by radius, okay, force into perpendicular distance. So here if we compare these two equations, and if you put here this mt, if you equate these two equations, okay, so you will get sb into r is equal to m sigma b, y dash r b in bracket 1 minus b divided by a naught plus b square by 3 a naught. Okay, so this will be your equation. Now this r will get cancelled, and you will get sb is equal to m sigma b y dash then b in bracket. Now this r and this r is cancelled. Okay, so here b 1 minus b by a naught plus b square by 3 a naught. Okay, now the face width of the bevel gear is limited to, the face width of the bevel gear is limited to 1/3 of the cone distance. Okay, so here cone distance is there, and it is limited to 1/3 of the cone. Now see here, if you are comparing the face width, so it is a naught and face width. If you are comparing, so face width is 1/3 of a naught. Okay, and if you are taking here, so it will, this third term will be very small. Okay, so you can neglect this third term. So if we are neglecting the third term, so your sb will become m b, okay, into sigma b into y dash in bracket 1 minus b by a naught. So this will be the final equation of beam strength for the bevel gear, and this equation is called as Lewis equation. Lewis equation for bevel gears. Okay, and here sb is nothing but the beam strength of the tooth, then m is nothing but the module at the large end of the tooth, b is the face width in mm, sigma b is nothing but the permissible bending stress, and you can find sigma b by sut by 3. Sigma b is equal to ultimate tensile strength divided by 3. From this you can find in newton per mm square. Then y dash is nothing but Lewis form factor based on virtual number of teeth or formative number of teeth, z dash. Okay, and a naught is nothing but cone distance. Okay, cone distance, that is a naught. Okay, it is given here. And here the term 1 minus b by a naught, 1 minus b by a naught, this term is called as bevel factor. Okay, so bevel factor will be 1 minus a b by a naught. Now face width is generally considered as 10 module, or face width is equal to a naught by 3. Okay, whichever is smaller. okay. So out of these two values, whichever is smaller, you have to consider that value for the face width, okay, 10 module or a naught by 3. Thank you.